Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, I am gonna be talking about 10 beauty mistakes that you could be making and have no idea. So if you guys wanna see what they are, keep on watching. And if you're new here, welcome. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment below, follow me on Instagram at Kelly L. Kruger, and subscribe to my blog, MadisonCharles.com. Okay, let's get right into it. Beauty mistake number one, not wetting your beauty blender. Now let me show you the difference. This is a dry beauty blender, and this is a wet beauty blender. They are the exact same thing. Sorry, this is dirty, I just used it. When it's wet, it expands. When it's dry, it doesn't. That's so blonde. The texture is different, which means that the way it's gonna put your product on is completely different. And don't ever rub your beauty blender on your skin. It's always a patting motion. So, wet your beauty blender, dry it in a towel, dab, 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 no rubbing, and no dry beauty blenders. Beauty mistake number two, putting concealer just under your under eyes. If you only put your concealer right under where the dark circles are, that's how you end up with raccoon eyes. So you want to bring it all the way down there. And then with your wet beauty blender, you wanna dab it in. So what this is gonna do is it's gonna brighten your that whole area. So the light's gonna reflect really nicely. Everything's gonna be really blended, as opposed to this is the no. A lot of people will just put it right here and only blend it like that. If your concealer is too light and you're really trying to lighten dark circles too, you're really gonna see that in photos and probably in person too. So number three, we'll stick with concealer, is putting your concealer on before foundation. Now, let me explain what I mean by this. If you want a really natural look and you just wanna conceal a couple little things and go with like a very natural look, totally put your concealer on where you want to and lightly put your foundation wherever. But if you're going for like a full coverage look, do not put your concealer on before the foundation. Put your foundation on first, and then for me, for example, I have like a little hyperpigmentation here that always pops through. It's old acne scarring. It always pops through my foundation no matter what, so I always go in with the concealer right after, and I pat it on with my beauty blender, and then I powder, and it's perfect. That's number three, concealer after foundation, and you might not really need as much as you think. Number four, water. This is so obvious to me, but so many people don't drink water. You should be drinking at least 3 liters of water every day. Build up to that. If you're someone who doesn't drink a lot of water, start with a liter a day. It's gonna make your skin glow. It's gonna keep your skin clear. It's gonna help circulation. It's just gonna help with everything. So aim for 3 liters of water a day. Side note, try and stay away from plastic and stick with glass. Just drink your water. Number five, not sleeping on a silk pillowcase. This is the slip pillowcases. They're great. I'm gonna link everything below. You can get them now at Sephora, on Amazon. Sleeping on a silk pillowcase is gonna do so many things. Number one, better for your hair. It's also good for preventing wrinkles. Sleeping on a silk pillowcase is a beauty tip that's been around for a really long time. And I started doing it, and then I really noticed a big difference in my hair and my skin. Number six, always use a heat protector on your hair. I love this, it's a 10. It's a leave-in conditioner, inhibits hair breakage, it creates silkiness, it seals and protects color. I've been using this, I've been such a fan. I wanna say like for like, the last at least 5 years. And then the other thing that I've been using is this Isles formula. It prevents breakage and it prevents damage, but it also actually repairs your hair. This has been a lifesaver. So for number seven, this also seems so obvious to me, but I'm really surprised at how many people would be like, I do that all the time. Doing your foundation and your face before your eyes. Here's the thing, I do my base a lot before I do my eyes. Sometimes what happens is you do your whole face and then you do your eyes and you've got covered in, and unless you're a professional makeup artist who knows how to swipe away and or put powder, I don't even know because I don't even know the technique. I end up always taking a simple wipe and cleaning under my eyes and like almost shaping my eyeshadow with the simple wipe. So if you do your whole base and you do your concealer and everything and then you do your eyes, you're wiping it off and having to do double the work, which who wants to work double? Nobody, I certainly don't. Do your eyes first, then do your base. It'll make your life so much easier. Number eight, supplements. I love fish oil. Cod liver oil, I think, is just an amazing supplement to take daily for so many things. It helps with everything from your cardiovascular health, helps with brain health and your joints. It's just so, so good for you. It also helps make your skin glow. It's disgusting. This one actually has like a little lemon, but it's still disgusting and you end up burping it up, but it's so worth it, so take it. Also take a multivitamin every day. Number 9, using talc. Anything with powder is generally gonna have talc in it, because that's what it is. Talc and mica are normally gonna be the two ingredients in any setting powder, blush, anything that you use. Any opportunity that you have to get talc free, get it. Now, if you're acne prone, you should never be using talc ever. Laura Mercier makes a universal setting powder, which is talc free. It's amazing. I am a loyal fan to it. I really highly suggest like that would be the setting powder to go to. It is non-comedogenic, which means that it will not clog your pores. Read your ingredients, and if you can stay away from talc, get rid of it. Number 10, sticking with skincare, using too many acne products. If you're acne prone, as I am, and I battled with acne for so many years, I wish somebody would have told me this, which is why I want to share it with you guys. When you use acne products, generally they're very harsh, they're very drying. When you are drying your skin out too much, your skin is going to overcompensate by trying to produce more oil to balance out your skin naturally, and it's gonna cause you to break out more. You may need one acne product or one product that is maybe a drying lotion or an exfoliator. Please make sure that you're balancing that with moisture, and don't be afraid of oils. I am somebody who was like, everything has to be oil-free. I'm gonna break out. I break out from everything. Essential oils are different than the bad oils that clog your pores and cause breakouts. Essential oils can be very healing on your skin, and they can actually prevent breakouts. So do your research. My skin actually cleared up when I stopped using acne products. It's not one size fits all. So experiment with it, test it. Always when you're trying new products, never try a whole line at once. Try one thing at a time. Give it a couple days, see how your skin reacts, and then you can start introducing other things. It's pretty much my top 10. There are a lot of beauty mistakes that we make daily that we don't realize. Touching your face with dirty hands, putting your cell phone up to your cheek, clean your brushes daily, never sleep with your makeup on. These are like obvious ones, but I probably could keep going, but I don't wanna overwhelm you guys. So if you like the video, let me know, comment below, and let me know what else you guys wanna see. Okay, bye. Thanks for watching.